Kabari Wiri will be interviewing the amazing Ayana Ahmed and Chip Gross. Take it away, Omari.
My first question is Brighthouse a family-oriented space where you can just bring your child to work?
Or one of our values is family is everything. And so we are a home and we view each other as family and we understand the importance of family. So your kids are always welcome to come into the office. I think for us, they can learn from us, but I think we actually learn a lot from having kids around. It allows us to operate from a place of childlike wonder and curiosity and to play. And all of those things are actually very important to the work that we do, with purpose as well as coming up with big ideas.
So you mentioned purpose. Mm-hmm. So how did you figure out your purpose, or have you figured out your purpose?
Yeah, I think for all of us, you know, for trying to find ways to make the biggest impact in the world, you know, a big part of that is understanding your purpose or how you fit into it. So, you know, my purpose, at least the way that I describe it, is helping to bring optimism, lead with optimism. And a lot of the things that I've done in my past, as well as things that I strive to do here at Brighthouse, is all about helping to kind of illuminate and bring more awareness, knowledge, and ideally, you know, motivate others to make a bigger impact on the world. So we do that through the teams that we have that work with our clients. We do that in the work that we do outside in our own personal time, as well as the work that we do in concert with other agencies. So, you know, for us, you know, as you can tell, purpose is at the heart of everything that we do, and it's really critical that we all have a way of kind of communicating what that purpose is.
Yeah, I think my purpose, or if I said it before, is reflect the light that I see in the world. And I think immediately what that looks like is really infusing humanity into business, and that's what we do at Brighthouse. Often you think that business is really straight-laced and, you know, you're kind of asked to act like robots, but the reality is that we're humans and there's a place for emotion and empathy and storytelling, and I think that's the work that I'm meant to do. And so Brighthouse feels like a stop or one place where I can really cultivate and live my purpose. But your purpose is lifelong, and you'll find many different ways and many different places to live your purpose and understand it and embody it at a deeper level.
So what type of challenges have you faced in your field of work, and how have you overcome them?
One, add value as well as help companies become better. And that's what I've always found, you know, really engaging. And to me, you know, finding that right company was in some ways the biggest struggle, as well as sometimes just recognizing that, you know, coming into a company that maybe hasn't been as diverse, there's always kind of the challenge of having to ensure that people give you the respect and the opportunity to do really good work. And sometimes I've been in environments that's been very easy, and sometimes I've gone in environments where, you know, you kind of have to really recognize that there's a few more things that are, you know, gonna work against you, and you have to find ways to rise above them.
You know, especially today, now more than ever, you can find work environments that support who you are. Mm-hmm. You don't have to hide or try to fit in anymore, right? You can find work environments, and you deserve to be in work environments that support who you are fully and that are conducive for you, your purpose, and your growth.
How did traveling help you find who you are?
Oh my God, it was everything, especially at a young age. It, you know, your environments very much shape who you are. So if you've only stayed where you know, you identify yourself by that place. But there's something really powerful about removing yourself from everything that you know and putting yourself in a completely new context. And I think traveling at a young age showed me who I was beyond what my friends, my neighborhood, and my community reflected. I not only got to see myself, I saw myself in a new light because I had to do all these things, you know? I had to talk to people who don't speak the same language as me, right? And you really see yourself in those moments where, how am I when I'm in an unfamiliar place? And I found that I actually love and I really enjoy exploring. I like meeting new people. I'm able to connect with people who are different than you, because you realize what makes everybody the same is universal. You realize a smile anywhere you go, everybody knows what a smile means, and they'll smile back. You know, you realize kindness, generosity, compassion is valued everywhere.
Well, if you can give one piece of advice to your younger self today, what would that advice be?
I think what I would tell myself is that as much as I think I know what the plan is for what I'm going to become, you probably have no idea. And, you know, you need to be flexible and recognize that, you know, sometimes your kind of career will go like this, sometimes it will go like this, but at the end of the day, you know, as long as you keep moving forward, you'll make progress, and, you know, you're kind of the sum of all the different experiences that you have. And I think what makes you really better is being able to not just have the successes, but also recover from things that might be, you know, short-term challenges, and know that, you know, you're resilient and, you know, you can still be very successful.
A man is but the product of his thoughts, what he thinks, and what he becomes. Mahatma Gandhi.
My quote is, to be early is to be on time, to be on time is to be late, and to be late is unacceptable.
All right. A quote that I use, I think it might have even been from my high school graduation, but the quote is, where the body fails, the mind prevails. And I think in many cases, we try to do things kind of through brute force. And, you know, in many cases, the way to be successful is to think things through and plan and find ways to use your mind as well as your body to, you know, meet new challenges.
I think I would quote the Margaret Mead quote in the front, which is, never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens